How do you create a recurring meeting in Zoom on, say, the first Monday of the month and the third Monday of the month? As far as I can see, the bad news is you can't do it easily, but there is a workaround. So let me show you. So the first Monday of the month is not a fixed day, okay? Because the first Monday of this month might be the 7th, and of next month might be a different day in the first 7 days of the week. So what you can do in Zoom is to create a monthly meeting, okay? And we'll call it first Monday of the month. And you select the first Monday or starting of next month. So that's the 7th of September at the time that I'm creating. You set the time zone. And I'm saying that this meeting is a recurring meeting and it's going to recur on the first Monday of the month. And that will continue, you know, for this until this time or after so many occurrences. And so that's going to continue on the first Monday of the month. So we create that first meeting. And then you send it to whoever the invitees are. And then you can create another meeting. Schedule a meeting and say, okay, and this is the third Monday of the month. A bit of a problem, and I'll show you why it's a problem, but we're going to go for the third Monday of the month, which is 1, 2, 3. So that's going to be, so the 21st is the next Monday of the month. Check the time and so on. And I'm going to make that recurring meeting, and we'll say that it's monthly, and it's going to repeat every month on the third Monday of the month. Okay, and then I still have to do an end date. Can you do it with no end date? Apparently not. Okay, can we leave that blank? We can't. Huh. Okay, so that's how we do it, is you create one meeting for the first Monday, one for the third Monday of the month. And once again, you save that. Now, the problem with this is that if you want to change things on the meeting, change the list of invitees, change the content of the meeting, the agenda and so on, or any of these other settings, such as whether the video is on for participants or off when they join the meeting, then you've really got to do that for the two separate meetings. Similarly, if you need to stop this meeting, then you want to stop this regular meeting on the first Monday and on the third Monday of the month. Now, is there another way around it? Well, not in Zoom. And also, I'm using Google Calendar. And in Google Calendar, it's the same thing, is that in Google Calendar, when you create a meeting, and so in Google Calendar, when you create a meeting, once again, you can say, I'm going to create this meeting in Google Calendar on the first Monday of the month, which is the 7th. And then you can say repeat, but once again, you're monthly on the first Monday of the month. That's repeating. Now, Google Calendar does have this advantage that you can have an unlimited number of meetings. So you don't have to have an end date or a fixed number of meetings. So that's on the first Monday of the month. Can we do it to custom instead? Custom doesn't allow us to change change it from, you know, the first Monday and the third Monday of the month. So we've still got a problem on Google Calendar. But what Google Calendar also does, and so this is setting it up in Google Calendar, in your calendar it may be different if you're using Outlook or something else, is you can then add video conferencing and then you specify your Zoom meeting. I have another video showing how to do that so that in Google Calendar you'll have this option for the Zoom meeting video conferencing. But the short answer is you need to create one entry for the first Monday of the month and another one for the third Monday of the month. However, if you use another tool, another calendar tool, such as Schedule Once or Calendly or some of those other calendar tools, they may allow you to specify first and third Monday of the month. If you found this helpful, then consider subscribing to my channel, where I share information that's going to help you connect with your clients and speak their language.